cataract media has been continuously evolving over the past couple of years, with more than 50 procedures described over the past 5 decades. But not only did the type of the procedure evolve, but also how we do it, our approach. Historically, we used to do bariatric surgery using an open technique, and obviously this had its own setbacks. It wasn't until the early 90s when Wipro first introduced the concept of laparoscopic bariatric surgery. And at that time, of course, we started realizing all the benefits of laparoscopic surgery. But yet again, this still left the patient with a couple of scars. For some, it was fine and non-concerning, but for others, you can see that it's bad, ugly, and really concerning to some of them. From this standpoint, we described the bikini line sleeve gastrectomy, where we placed all of our trochers below the bikini line. Believe it or not, all of those patients had a sleeve gastrectomy with the bikini line technique. So as far as the technique, it's the same as a conventional technique, but with only a different approach. We placed the patient in the split leg position, but we only kept the degree of leg splitting at a narrower angle to facilitate the suturing phase, the last phase of the procedure. And when we came to strapping the patient to the table, we made sure that this yellow area was completely dead. So we placed our leg straps at a lower level than usual. We accessed the peritoneum using a closed loop peritoneal technique. We used the umbilicus to introduce our trocar, a beautiful natural scar, to line up with our scar. And after that, we subsequently placed all of the remaining trochers all beneath the bikini line. In some patients, we rarely ever needed to use a liver retraction, but for others, when we needed one, we used the subxiphoid area to introduce either a small varus needle or a narrow caliber K1. Sometimes we introduce a fourth trocar again in the bikini line and introduce a long liver retractor. This video shows our use an optical trocar for the closed loop peritoneal technique. And once we're in, in this video I'll show how we carefully design our trocar placement all below the bikini line in one of the natural spaces. We use 2 5-millimeter ports on either side, as you can see here. And once we're in, we introduce the 10-millimeter port, which would be the camera port, just below and to the right of the umbilical port. And this is the final view in a couple of different patients. As you can see here, and the view within action. So the following is a short clip of the procedure. As you can see, the camera is introduced in the 10-millimeter port above the symphysis pubis in the bikini line. And we start our procedure just like in a normal sleeve with the gastric mobilization phase. At this phase, as you can see, the surgeon stands on the right of the side of the patient. And as you can see, I'm using the umbilical port and the left 5-millimeter port for my right and left working hand. Then we continue our dissection downwards towards the pylorus, 2 to 3 centimeters from the pylorus. And then we break down any posterior gastric adhesions. And then work our way upwards towards the angle of this, completely mobilizing and visualizing the left crust. Then we move to the gastric stapling phase. At this point, the surgeon moves from the right side of the patient to in between the patient's leg. And we introduce the stapler through the umbilicus. And by the way, all the filing are done through the umbilicus. Once everything is in position, we start and commence our filing, aiming at achieving the best possible alignment for the stapler line, as you can see. So we routinely cover our staple line with a running free or pro lead, and we don't want to change our protocol with this technique. And we were successful in all of our patients to cover our staple line with the sutures. Finally, we extract the stomach from the umbilicus at the end of the operation. In those four videos, I'll demonstrate the same technique, but in different patients. As you can see, we rely on bariatric leg reusable instruments in all of our ports, and it was found feasible to use standard length staplers and energy source. However, if you want to pamper yourself, just get the external ones, they'll be fine. As you can see in the lower left video, we routinely close our port site to avoid any instances of burning, which we never had one. Good. So as far as the cosmetic results, so these are the immediate post-op pictures. You can barely notice the scars. At 10 days, this patient came to my office asking where are her scars. Obviously, she couldn't see them because they were hidden below the folds. I had to ask her to raise her abdominal fold so I can see her scars. And for the umbilical scar, I had to really zoom in and focus to be able to see. This is another patient, 10 days, all scars hidden. And a longer follow-up, this picture on the left is always in the 10-day, and at 2 months follow-up, this patient came again, scars hidden below the bikini line. 3 months follow-up, lost weight, hidden scars, all below the bikini line. Another patient at 3 months, lost some weight, had to ask her to raise the bra a little bit and her blouse in order to be able to see the subsequent scar. And as you can see at the bottom here, the scars are still hidden below the bikini line. At 6 month follow-up, patient lost a lot of weight, no scars. And this patient at 1 year lost a considerable amount of weight. I had to ask her to raise her full swim to be able to see the scars, and for the subject for the scars to completely vanish. So, in conclusion, this was a pilot study of a small number of patients that is actually currently in submission. It showed a comparable operative time, comparable weight loss, and definitely a higher level of satisfaction. However, we still need to study more patients with longer follow-up and possibly a competitive study. Thank you for your time. Thank you.